Good evening and welcome to Telford Ice Rink for a rather snowy weekend weather-wise, but the game against Slough at home on Sunday night is the only game this week that's gone ahead for the TRS Telford Tigers. So let's have a word with manager Paul Thomason ahead of tonight's game against the Slough Jets. So due to the bad weather, no game against Peterborough yesterday, just a one-game weekend. How are things looking ahead of the Slough Jets game tonight?
Things are looking okay. Disappointed we didn't play last night because we're probably having a little bit rusty legs because we haven't trained since Thursday. But we're working on a lot of things this week in zone coverage, and we worked hard, so hopefully the guys went on the treadmills and on the bikes yesterday to keep the legs going, so hopefully we should come out flying tonight.
Thank you very much. Let's take a look at tonight's action.
This is my favourite away team intro. The TRS Telford Tigers, wearing number 31, Declan Ryan, sponsored by the Park in Telford. Wearing number 3 is sponsored by the Park in Marcus Maynard. Wearing number 8, sponsored by Globe, Bingo Donington, Ryan Selwood. Wearing number 10, sponsored by Libyan Autos, Luke Brittle.
Good evening and welcome to Telford Ice Rink for tonight's clash as the TRS Telford Tigers take on the Slough Jets. Last time they played, it was a win in overtime for the Slough Jets. Can Tom Watkins' men redress the balance as they play tonight here at Telford Ice Rink? Mackenzie wins the draw, goes back into the D zone, and it's sent down the ice. It's picked up by Godfrey in the defence for the Slough Jets as they start off their breakout. Kulikov takes a hit in the corner. Mackenzie holds him up. Priest sends the puck around the boards, and Burrows battles in the corner to gain possession for the TRS Telford Tigers. Puck's cleared out by Marcus Maynard. Michael Wales picks it up. Cross ice, comes to neutral ice, intercepted well. Maynard fires it on net, takes a deflection up into the netting. And the hit's finished off on Karpov, but there was a bit of an elbow back there. Michael Wales, no stranger to controversy from the Slough team. Deep in the end zone. Battle for the puck. Davis fires it in. Comes over the top. Watkins. Karpov. Big hit from Wales, that's the first penalty. Michael Wales, I would imagine, elbowing at a guess. Back to Burrows. Kruzak's in the high slot. Just coming down low to try and get that shooting opportunity. Comes up to him in the high slot. Sends it back to Karpov. Cycling well. Karpov winds up, fires it to the back door. Comes into the open slot. Loose puck comes out to Cruiser. Fires it in. Great catching mitt save from the netminder. Greg Rogman in between the pipes for the Slough Jets. Takes a deflection, but now Slough on the break. Delayed play. Knocked on, but picked up well by Karpov. Drives forward to the blue line. Delays it to Mackenzie. Winds up for the shot. Fires up into the blocker, where Rockman made a great save, but he was looking for the top left-hand corner, and it was looking good for where we're standing. Lights drop to normal conditions now at the Telford Ice Rink. Hopefully it won't be long. Burrows passes it from the back of the net. That was Mackenzie to Karpov, and then Burrows is stood in front and fires it into the back of the net. So an even-handed goal from the TRS Telford Tigers. Off the draw, Kulikov up to the point, big shot from the point and a goal for the Slough Jets. It was Kulikov that got it off the draw, then sent it up to the defence, but I'm not quite sure which one it was, just wait for the referee to clarify the numbers involved. But it was definitely a clean pass from the point up to the shooter. 10 seconds remaining. Kruzak, Burrows, round the boards. Mackenzie, long pass to Priest, goes forward, Rockman saves it, and that's the end of the first period. Telford Tigers 1, Slough Jets 1. A few words being exchanged in front of Rockman with Priest involved, and guess what? Michael Wales is stuck right in the middle of it once again. First period, TRS Telford Tigers 1, Slough Jets 1 at the end of the first period. Crofts getting in there for the Telford Tigers as well. Okay, so here we go, second period. 1-1 the score. Telford win the draw. Cusack sends it up, Burrows knocks it on. This Cusack just makes a hit on Burrows in neutral ice. The stick comes up high, hits his own player across the net. There's some clutching and grabbing down there in the corner between Priest and I think it was Dan Scott. Goes cross ice, what icing's washed off. Backhand now, Slough hold the puck on the net, very dangerous, but luckily for Declan Ryan, both the Slough players are behind the net. Backhanded pass intercepted well by the Slough defence, so now Slough on the breakout. Cross ice. Backrick sends it deep into the corner. Comes back out with it. Tries to wrap round and tries to get the shot across. And it was 55 waiting in front. Got a bit of wood to the stick. That's Velko. But Declan Ryan saved it well for the TRS Telford Tigers. Referee's telling them to play it. And now Slough do so. Comes across to neutral ice. Dan Scott picks it up in the defensive end for Slough. Looks for the long pass forward. Defenseman passing it between them. Scott banks it off the boards to find Velenko. Long makes the shot. Ryan makes the save. Brittle off the boards. Karpov tries to put it in, but now Slough make the shot and goal. A good turnover for the Slough Jets. There was Kieran Long involved in that one, and I think it was Velenko as well, but we'll just wait for the official confirmation on the second Slough goal.
74
is out to the point. Cusack, but a good stick poke and a good recovery from Cusack. Watkins waits for the Tigers to clear the zone, passes it across to Karpov. There's a slash coming in there, I'm sure there was, from the Slough player. But he got a little frustrated when he got ejected from the face-off. So, getting quite tough physically out there now. Burrows banks it off the boards. But it's Kapus. Slough, get it in front, reach round, and a goal, for a short-handed goal for the Slough Jets. Comes right across the high slot. And it was Pluskowski, I think, that generated the play. Yannick takes a knock on from Priest. Goes deep. Slough picking up at the back of the net. Priest is there. Cusack. Back of the net, in front. It's loose, and it's saved down. Slough, 26 long. Delays it into the corner, looks for the high slot. Kieras makes the shot. Blocked well by Bowley. Karen Bowley on the break now. Hits the blue line, he's away. He makes the shot. Rockman, and it was Karen Bowley to get the shot away. He picked it up at the halfway line, drove hard. I thought Rockman had got it covered. I think he got a pad to it, but it went over the top and into the left-hand corner as we look at it from the bench to make the Tigers' second goal. Great work from Karen Bowley, and of course, the pass to feed it forward to him to give him that break. And a second shot from Karpov. It's delayed. He comes in slowly. He lets the shot go from just inside the blue line. And bang, hits the five hole to put Telford back in the game as it comes up to 3-3. So here we go on the third period, 3-3, the tied game. Let's see what will happen in the third. McKenzie wins the draw, dumps it over the top. Clutch and grab. Neutralised, Brittle drops it back to Karpov. It's good work from Karpov, and Brittle passing the puck well. Cuts inside, good hands, but the puck drifts, he's still got it. Cruiser. Wales. Plakowski drives the net hard. Oh, he's got a hook across there. There was a hook blatantly across Cruiser, but the puck was with Declan Ryan, so he wasn't pulling him away from the puck. I think there's a strong possibility of an interference penalty had he have had the puck or been near it. Kieras. Big shot into the body of Declan Ryan. The rebound's picked up, and it's a goal for Slough Jets. Declan Ryan made the save, but 83 was there with that long reach to pick up the puck and fire it into the back of the net, making it 4-3 to the Slough Jets on 52 minutes and 46 seconds. Telford really hustling to get it up. 8 seconds remaining. Long pass forward to Burrows. He reaches forward. Slough cut across. And that's going to conclude the game with the Slough Jets 4, the Telford Tigers 3. Great game of hockey.
A good performance tonight.
We lost.
You did.
So it can't be good. I think they have to man up in there and accept that winning is our goal. And the good performances are not good performances. You don't win. You know, you're not going to get anything for nothing. I thought we played okay, yeah, fine. But it come down to, you know, four or five shifts in the hockey game that we were on the wrong side of pucks, or we made bad decisions. You know, we missed a lot of chances, I think, tonight. Good opportunities, which, you know, at 3-3, I think we had a great opportunity to go 4-3 up. That cost us. We lose two D-zone face-offs clean. Two shots from the point, which result from that, they go in the back of the net. And a shot and a goal. You know, that's defining moments in the hockey game.
For sure. Now, in that second period, you slipped two goals down. One of the things that you've pulled up on in the past few weeks is when their heads drop, but they did pull back out of that.
No, credit to the guys. It was, you know, 3-1 and we come back 3-3 with two quick goals, but you have to carry that momentum on and make sure that you get the fourth. And even after we scored our third goal, we were guilty of making a bad decision, and we ended up with a goal mouth scramble at the front of our net, and that can't really happen, because you know what, you're gifting the momentum straight back to the other team with that sort of play. Once you get it, after a two-goal lead, I honestly would have thought we would have gone on and win the hockey game. But you know what, we didn't.
And nice to have Declan back out on the ice.
Great to have Declan back on the ice. He brings a lot to the team, a lot of confidence in him. It was good to have Thomas Yannick back on the ice as well, which gave us, you know, the opportunity to play Senko up front with Karpov. And again, I think it's the first time this season where we've had a full lineup.
So that concludes this evening's game on Tigers TV. Don't forget, next week, the TRS Telford Tigers are at home on Saturday night when they play the Steel Dogs, and Andre Priet's team return to the Telford Ice Rink. Then on Sunday, the trip down south to Guildford.